If you love anything MIDI related, such as covers and tutorials, check out my other videos and be sure to subscribe. So, yeah, the first step to use a plugin in Ableton is to install it in Ableton. So how do you do that? Well, first of all, step one is to make a custom folder in which you install all your plugins. So I will show you mine here. I've just called this map of VST plugins, and here are all my plugins. So the plugin mostly has a file extension of .dll. And you can just, if you download a plugin, there are a lot of free plugins on the internet, you can just copy them to this map. So for example, at the instrument tab, I have a, yes, a bass DLL. Okay, so then go to Ableton. And here you can see on the categories, the placed plugins. So all my plugins are listed here. But this is not so if you just started using Ableton, because you have to select a custom plugin map in order to make the instruments, for example, the bass, show up here. Okay, so how do you do that? You go to Options, you go to Preferences, and then on the library, no, sorry, on the plugins, you have to enable Use VST Plugin Custom Folder and set it on. And then what you have to do is browse and set the plugin folder to the folder I just showed you. So this is the file path to my VST folder. So also, you can just enable it here, select the map, and then press rescan. And then if it all works, you should see all the plugins you have added here. So this is for the VST2 plugins. You also have VST3 plugins. They are a new form of plugins. And so also set your custom folder here to the file path you added all your custom folders. As you can see, it also takes over the file structure. So that's really handy if you have a lot of love plugins. And then in order to use a plugin, just select the plugin that you want and drag it to a free track. And then you can see it it opens, and you can, for example, now play with the AGMTL bass.